later in this service, I will testify of my miracle. Lift your voice, let somebody talk to God right now. I will testify of my miracle. Any day now. Oh yes, in the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and talk to God right now. I will testify of my miracle. Oh yes. Oh yes, our Father, in the name of Jesus, I will testify my miracle. Oh yes, my Father, in this service, I will testify my miracle. Thank you, King of Glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Heavenly Father, your word said, come to me, all ye that labored and every laden, and I will give you rest. Father, we have come. Let our issue be settled. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, let every unsettled aspect of our life, by your settled word, let them be settled. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, let everyone this morning have an encounter with your settled word. Thank you, King of Glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Help me to turn into your neighbor and say, my neighbor, you are welcome to church. Put your hands together for the Lord and have your seat this morning. Hallelujah. On behalf of Jesus, the head of the church, you are welcome this morning to God's presence. And I believe God strongly that you will not regret of coming today in the name of Jesus. Why? Today is our covenant day of settlements. We believe in God that settles men. Our God is in the business of settlements. There is no issue that cannot be settled by God. There is no case that God cannot settle. Every genuine encounter with God of settlement enforces the settlements of man. And the Bible says, your word is settled, O Lord, forever. You can't encounter the settled world and not be settled by the word of God. And I believe God this morning that that aspect of your life that look like important, you shall be settled by God. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Men and brethren, why settlement? Every apprentice look forward for settlement. Am I right? Every apprentice look forward for a day of settlement. Settlement establish the establishment of man. Settlement is the pathway to establishment. In the business world, men are settled to be established. Am I right? Until your boss settles you, you cannot be established. The reason why you are here this morning, so that you can be established by God. And that is why he must settle you this morning. Amen. I say God must settle you this morning. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, he must settle you this morning. Amen. He must settle you this morning. Amen. First Peter chapter 5. First Peter chapter 5. And look at what the word of God has to say. Verse 8 to verse 10. First Peter chapter 5. Verse 10 said, he said, for the God of all grace, who has called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you have suffered a while. May I ask you this morning, have you suffered a while? After you have suffered a while, I believe you have suffered a while. You are going through some others. After you have suffered a while, and make you perfect and established and strengthens and settles you. After you have suffered a while, he will make you perfect. He will stabilize you. He will strengthen you, and he will crown it with what? Settlement. God is going to settle someone here with heart-shaping testimony. In the name of Jesus Christ, if you are the one I'm talking to, take it this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ, and so shall it be. In Jesus' precious name. This morning, I want to share with us on the teaching that we commence. We have been exploring a teaching that is titled Uncovering the Root of the Faith That Works. Uncovering the roots of the faith that works. Here these men are better. There is nothing without a root. There is nothing without a root. There is nothing in existence without a root. Whether good or bad, everything and anything has a root. To every affliction, there is a root. To every success, there is what? A root. To every battle, there is a root. To every challenge, there is a root. To every sickness, there is a root. To every problem, there is a root. And to every prosperity, there is what? A root. Nothing works without a root. It is the root of faith that determines the workings of faith. The root of faith determines the workings of faith. That is, there is no faith, no matter how big it is, no matter the measure of faith, there is no faith without a root. Every measure of faith has a root. Permit me to say this morning, the root of faith is nothing but the foundations of faith. When we talk about the root of faith, we are talking about the foundations of faith. The foundations of faith. There is nothing without a foundation. The foundations of a thing determine the manifestations of a thing. The manifestations of faith can be traced to the foundations of faith. Psalm 11 verse 3. If the foundation be destroyed, what can what the righteous do? Now, let me digress a little. If you are a good student of Bible, you study your Bible very well, and you are familiar with the statement of Bible, you will discover in the Bible sometimes God state problems before he state the cause of the problem. Am I right? When you study your Bible very well, you will discover that God will describe the problem first before he will now mention the cause of the problem. And sometimes also, God will discuss we state the cause before we will not talk about the consequences of the cause. But in this case, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? That question was not answered. Go to verse 4. Verse 4 of that scripture. I believe that question is supposed to say, and the Lord is in his holy temple. Is he a good response? No, if you understand the question very well. The Lord is what? Is his only response, is his only temple. The Lord, the Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold, his eyes try the children of men. Verse 5. And the Lord tried the righteous, but the wicked and him that loveth violence is so what? Eternal. Continue. Upon the wicked, he shall rain snare and fire and brimstone and all the tempest. This shall be the portion of the cause. And for the righteous God, love what righteous say, his countenance do what? Behold what? The upright. Now, all this scripture we read now, does it answer the question that was answered by sleep? No. Does it have something to do with sleep? If the foundation be faulty, what can the righteous man do? Is a question that is being left for you and me to answer. That question was deliberately put there by the organogram of heaven so that you, an individual, will determine the answer. When we talk about faith, there is no faith without a root. There is no faith without a foundation. And when the foundation of faith is faulty, the operations of faith will be faulty. When the foundations of faith is faulty, the operations of faith will be faulty. And that is the reason why we are trying to uncover the root of faith, to uncover the foundations of faith. Hear this, men of men, whatsoever that affect the foundations of faith, affect the operations of faith. The reason why many cannot operate in faith because their foundations of faith is faulty. Praise the Lord. Whatsoever that affects the root of a thing affect also the products of that thing and affect the fruit of that thing. Faith has foundation. Faith has root. Faith has root. When we are talking about the root of faith, we are talking about the taproot of faith. The fundamental factor that makes it work is what we mean by the fruit, the root of it. The root of faith are the fundamental factors that make faith productive, that make faith effective, that make faith work. And when this fundamental factor is negatively affected, the operations of faith also be negatively what? Affected. Uncovering the roots of faith that works. What is faith? Here is why must we define faith? Because the definitions of faith determine the directions of faith. Where there is no definition, confusion is bound to happen. Am I right? Yes, sir. But where there's divination, confusion is eliminated and prevented. What is faith? Number one, faith is a living force drawn from the living world to produce living proof among living people. Faith is a living force drawn from the living word of God to produce living proof among the living people. Among the living. It's a living force that is drawn from the word of God to produce living proofs among the living. Among the living. Among the living. Based on my perception and my perspective, here they say, faith is to produce living proof among the living, not among the dead. Faith is not just a talk. Faith is a drawable force. A drawable. It's a force to draw. And that's why the Bible said, he said, taking the sheet of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench the fiery dart of the wicked. What does that mean? Faith is a drawing force. That is, faith is a taking force. In the journey of life, the faith you take along, the time that you go along. In the journey of life, what you carry along matters a lot to your experience. Look at the small dam, daughter of Zion. Say, before I went into the theater, I could remember I took the communion before I enter into the theater. I pray for everyone here. Every devices of the enemy to claim your life this year expires. Oh, I say it expires. In the name of Jesus Christ. Just imagine, they take somebody into the theater and they discover that the gas they're supposed to use is leaking. Faith is not a dead force. Faith is a living force. Help me to tap your neighbor. Faith is not a dead force. Faith is a living force. It's a living force. Taking the sheet of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench the fiery darts of what? Of the wicked. You don't just talk faith, you take faith. Tell me to tell about you. Don't just talk faith. You take faith. You take it. It's in the Bible says, take. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 16. You say, take the sheet of faith. Before you enter the example, as you are entering with your mindset, with your calculator, don't leave faith behind you. Take it along. Everyone, read with me. Above all, say above all. Above your pen. Above your mindset, above what you have made, above what? Above what? Above all, taking the sheet of faith, where we shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. Many students enter the exam without taking faith along. And that is the reason why, when they enter the exam, you see them beating their head, knocking. When they were entering, they say faith does not matter. Above all. Above what? From today, you will not be stranded in the journey of life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Faith is available in the word of God. Faith.
faith is what?
Unfeasible in the word of God. I challenge you men every day. Get acquainted with the Bible. And take faith along. Here is, people of God, if you don't know how to draw faith, you'll be drowned by fear. You will what? Be drowned by fear. If you don't know how to draw faith. If you don't know how to draw faith from believing more, you'll be drowned by fear. Be drowned by fear. Man that knows how to draw faith from believing water can never be drowned by fear. Never be drowned by fear. Look at that daughter outside. She called me yesterday. She called me yesterday. I never knew that it was an emergency call. When she called me yesterday, she called me. I saw the missed call. I never knew that was an emergency. And that is the reason why I beg you, don't come to church to be entertained. Come to church to be fed. Because a day will come in your life, your pastor will know they're available.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The day will come in your life, your pastor what? Even your husband may not be available. He's available, but it's not reachable. He said, Pastor, what do you mean? I am not talking about your husband will die. He won't die. Are you with me at all? He won't die. He won't die. Let me use me as an example. I was the one that brought my wife to delivery. I never knew that she has. Is it dilated or delayed? You will remind me now. Is it dilated or what? Is it deleted or dilated?
Dilated.
I never knew she has dilated. Why she was still with me? She lied in my office. Like that. Oh, we enter the car, we cruise. We cruise. I drove her there. Oh, I drove her there to the hospital. That is Mina. I was sitting at the lobby. Was sitting there while she was in there. You know the place now. We can't go there. It's only them that can enter there. And when she was there, I was there. Men are ready. I was available there, but I was not eating with her. I was available. But I was available in the hospital. Or in the same block, but sir, I was not reaching at the thing she has not been touched. About the issue of faith. What I'm sharing with you today, the reverse will I want? Say God forbid. Number two. What is faith? Faith is the conscious act of putting God's word to work. Believing the challenging situation notwithstanding. Faith is the conscious act of putting God's word to work. Believing the challenging situation notwithstanding. That is, faith is engaging the word of God on any subject matter believing. The conscious act of putting God's word, engaging God's word, believing the challenging situation, not what we stand. May I shock you this morning that faith is never unconscious. Is never unconscious. Faith is conscious. Faith is ever conscious of what to do per time. What do you want? Genuine faith is not a conscious faith. Genuine faith is a conscious faith. Put in God's word to work. Believe. The challenging situation of understanding. Here it is. Life, so to say, is why life what? Pack. Battles of life are real to everybody. They are what?
Real.
The way our faces are different, the same way our challenges of it are what? Different. May I ask you this question now? Every stage of life enforces a change of prayer approach. I will explain. When you were in primary school, it was a prayer that, I want to go in secondary school. Am I right? The prayer you pray in primary school, even when you pray what? In secondary school. And you get to SS2. Oh, Lord, give admission to the car. You are praying admission, admission, admission. Now, God has given you admission to the car. And you discover the prayer you pray in primary and secondary, you don't need to pray that prayer in what? Now, in Unica, oh, Father, no missing result. In primary school, there is nothing like missing. A primary school, there does not do anything like missing result. Am I right? Yes. Even in secondary school, you don't do anything like what? Like, if you tell your miss, missing result, what do you talk? But when you now get to university, you say more pop. You say more pop. More pop. You just discover that all the prayer that is peculiar to the level you were before is not the same prayer that is peculiar to the level you are now. Yes. Am I right? Yes. As your level changes, the engagement of your faith also what? Yes. Father, in the name of Jesus, I need a young man that look like my pastor. I need a young man that is more spiritual. And before you know it, please don't blow one young guy across the way. You are prayed. Now that God has given a young man after the order of your desire, you are now praying, oh God, let my husband love me. My husband shall be distracted. You should know now. Say you see now, as your levels are changing, your engagement of faith is also what? You are not praying, oh God. Oh, as you go, give me focus. In the name of Jesus, for every discussion, I bind, I lose, I cast, I destroy. Oh God, give me focus. Changing. Oh, tell your neighbor, as we are aging, challenges are changing. Oh, tell our neighbor, as we are aging, challenges are changing. Is it not true? It's true. As we are aging, challenges what? Just imagine now. The Adventist student under my voice now. You see no man. Oh, their prayer is already what? Changing. Oh, give me good job. Oh, God has delivered me from Unicash. Can you put your hands together? Tell me, we are not in Unicash. You are in Unicash. Say Unicash. You are pretending like someone you don't know what you are going through. I make sure I hear, don't offend me. Lord, give me a job. I don't want this time to. Hey, she knows very well that I need to pay some bills. I need what? Cash. That is the reason why you must know how to engage faith. As we are aging, challenges are changing. As we are leaving one level to another, also. Here is the devil that fought you at the level you were. It's not the same devil that will fight you at the level you are. Huh? Because a change in levels is a change in devils. A change of levels is a change in devils. Because the devil that fought the power is not the same devil that fighting you next now. There are some devils in form of lecturer. I respect you. I am who? I am my little lady. I'm telling you, sir. One of my daughters came and met me. Hear me, sir. One of my daughters came here and met me. She was lamenting last week. Final yesterday. And the lecturer vowed that she must have expired here. Why? Because the lecturer demanded to sleep with her. And he deliberately failed her. Failed her first semester and failed her second semester. While I am telling you that are devils in form of a lecturer, I am not insulting them. I know what I'm saying. And I told her, go and meet that devil. And tell him that my pastor says, come and meet him before we deal with you. Go and meet him. Huh? I said, go and meet him. And tell him my pastor says, go and meet him. And if you bring his spirit on here, we will fight him one of us. That was what I gave up. I said, we are going to fight him in all angles. So that you will know that there are people you don't touch. We exercise faith. I'm still waiting for feedback. That is the reason why you have to grow in faith. You have to grow in faith. Say, grow in faith.
Grow in faith.
Put the word of God to work. Believing without minding the challenging, the raging situations. And that's why I beg you, men and brethren, never ever mock any believer that is going through challenges. Never. Never, sir. Never. If peradventure you are opportune to hear, please join them in prayers. Lord, help them to escape through. Because you don't know when it's going to be your own time to move. How do I know? The Bible said, many are the trouble of a righteous man. He said, but God delivered them from them all. That you are a righteous man or something, you won't be troubled. As far as you are in this life, trouble. You wear eye shoes, some people are angry. You know, it is better and pick you touch. You understand what I mean? It is better and pick you wear, and they are angry. You know what I'm saying? Them on you. They don't know. But they are angry. And that is the reason why you have to walk on your face. Tell your neighbor, walk on your face.
Walk on your face.
John chapter 2, verse 5. He said, whatsoever I tell you to do, do it. Number one, man. Number three, finally. Number three, what is faith? Faith is an act of sharing responsibility with God in the light of scripture so as to have one desired delivered. Faith is the act of sharing responsibility with divinity in the light of scripture so as to have one desired what delivered. Hear this, man of God. We serve the God of shared responsibility. Our God is a God of shared what? Responsibility. God believes in shared responsibility. He's a God of shared responsibility. Not the God of absolute responsibility. It's a God of shared responsibility. Sharing responsibility with divinity in the light of scripture so as to have one desire what? Delivered. What does that mean? Somebody said, they say, Pastor, what are you saying this morning? That our God is not the God of absolute what? Responsibility. He's the God of shared responsibility. Hear this. What does that mean? Faith does not make God absolutely responsible for the desired miracle. Faith does not make God absolutely responsible for our desired what? Miracle. Faith does not believe that God must do everything. Faith does not believe, my brother, that God must do what? Everything. Our God is a God of shared what? Responsibility. That is, He has a role to play, and you have what? A role to play. Do your part. Let me do what? My part. Now, hear this now. As a student, you speak in tongues in capital letter, but you don't go for lecture, and you don't do your assignment, and you don't read for exam. Will you pass? Your duty to read, to memorize, and to meditate. It is God's responsibility to remind you of what you have read. God cannot read for you. And that is the reason why. He said, when the enemy shall come like before, the Holy God will lift up a standard. If there is no standard, there is nothing to be lifted up. There is nothing, men and brethren, to be lifted up, sir. You have a role to play. Oh God, give me a husband. God, I give you one. But hear this, sir. Hear this, sir. Giving a husband to marry is different from living a, enjoying a happy home. Even though God give you a good man, if you have a bad character, it will crash. Is a God can give you an employment, but He can't keep it for you. That is where your character is needed. That is where your behavior is needed. That is where you need to accept responsibility to the punctual. You talk to your boss anyhow, who will fire you? You come the way you like. Oh, we are in the same church. Oh, boss, good morning. How was your life? Oh, I am more than a conqueror. You say, God bless you. Because, who's here this? A man that hires a man, fires the man. Whoever that hires you can fire you. And don't take it for granted. That is why you have to put one. That is why you have to live right and do this right. And the Bible said, when your obedience is fulfilled, then it can avenge what you did. is something you must do to move God to do what in his mind towards us. Lord, I need a job, I need a job, I need a job. You have been praying for job. And God has confirmed that he has given you a job. Prophecy here and there. But instead of you to wake up and dress and move around the town, you just be rolling, you tattooing like a woman that is just newly married and you are roaming about. If I catch you, now that you are praying, God, I need a job. Move around the town. Are you with me? That is how to start faith. Is that faith? That's how to start it. You have a role to play, and God has what? A role to play. Everyone has a role to play. Everyone has what? A role to play. God has a role to play. If you don't play your part, you cannot enjoy his part. If you don't play your role, you cannot secure his goals. John chapter 5, verses 1 to 5, and John chapter 21, verses 5 to 7. There is what God will do, and there is what you must do. Are you with me? Hear this now. Evangelism is one thing. If you go out for evangelism and your pastor cannot prepare good, you know what I mean. Your pastor now cannot prepare good messages for the invitee to be nourished with. They will come and go. That is the reason why God cannot be there for us. We are the one that will be there. He is the one moving men to come. We are the one man that is going to use now to feed them well. Everyone has role to play. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 6 to 7. He said, I, Paul, planted and put the water, and God bring the increase. God is not the planter, God is a multiplier. He said, I have planted and put the water, and God gave what the increase. There are three factors in this scripture that need to be considered: the man factor, the planter factor, the waterer factor, and the multiplier factor. If somebody is not planting, there is nothing to water. And if there is nothing to water, there is nothing to multiply. I pray that grace to share the responsibility with God. May God grant us in the name of Jesus Christ. Grace to do what we are meant to do. May God grant us in the name of Jesus Christ. And finally, the characteristics of faith that works. The characteristics of faith that works. The characters of faith that works. Number one, bold speaking. Bold speaking faith. The faith that works must be bold speaking faith. Bold speaking faith. Bold speaking. Faith does not work without talking. Faith does not work without speaking. Not anyhow speaking, but speaking boldly. Acts chapter 4. Verse 13 to 16, he said, now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John, and perceived that they were unlearned and ignorant men, they marveled, and they took knowledge of them that they are being with what? With Jesus. They were speaking boldly. Bold speaking matters a lot to faith. Hear this, men and brethren. One of the indicators of faith that work is bold speaking. How do I know that you have faith? By the way you talk. Your talkings reveal the operation of the faith in your heart. The words of man are the windows of the faith of man. The words of man are what? The windows of faith of man. How do we know your faith? How do we know that you are a faith-filled person by the way you talk? How do we know that you are a fearful person by the way you talk? Why? Utterance reveal appearance. The appearance of faith begins with the utterance of faith. The appearance of fear begins with the utterance of fear. Both speaking. But I'm not talking about both facing. You know, some people, when you look at them, they want to feel that they are being died. They don't burn their face. They burn their face. But face cannot silence the devil. The devil can never be intimidated by your bold face. And the only thing that can checkmate the devil is your bold speaking. Bold speaking. Speaking with audacity. Speaking with authority. Don't talk like vegetable. If medical is your desire, don't talk like vegetable. A thief come to your compound and knock the door. Oh, open it up! And you at the other end, you now responded like a vegetable. You are finished. Somebody knock the door. Open the door! I shoot you. And you a bastard! Because the person here does not know the nature of the person over here. How will your nature be revealed by the way you talk? And before you know it, and the other guy that come and said, Bingo, he will talk before. You see, fuck. She people tell him that there's a woman here. Can you hear the book? But they never knew that you are a woman, but you are talking like a man. Yeah. Oh, frog, let's go. Why? Before you talk. Someone, don't put it up. The way you talk is a proof that God has answered the prayer. Open it up. Motherfucker, open it up. I use it to threaten you. You know, if I've been to Lagos before, you will see Lagos, they will do like this. My sheleshe, my bigger. What is coming out of his mouth is more than the. And if you don't understand this, and you are behaving like a moron, oh, you are giving the guy a platform to harass you. But the born of father, pulling the mother, as if they talk with you, they move. When you give the guy or your hair, you say, Father, I don't understand. Please, I'm sorry. You know, sir, that is how like this. You know, the devil will begin to pass like you. He will pass like this and will finish you. Oh, God. But when you rose, I know the son of who I am, you foul death. Edit. It's as if I'm looking for nothing. Tell your neighbor, let us talk. Acts chapter 4, verse 3. Acts chapter 4, verse 3. Acts chapter 14, rather, verse 3. He said, long time therefore, abode, they speaking what boldly in the Lord. Acts chapter 14, verse 3. Abode, they speaking boldly. Men and brethren, learn how to speak boldly in the Lord. Are you with us all? Learn what, at what, speak what boldly. Don't talk like vegetable. Talk like the daughter of lion of the tribe of Judah.